Hello everyone, this is Professor Nayan from Department of Information Technology, Parathibai Genba Mose College of Engineering, Wagholi. So in this session we are going to see the activity diagram. So the activity diagrams are the graphical representation of workflows of stepwise activities and actions with support of choice, iteration and concurrency. It describes the flow of control of the target system, such as the exploring complex business rules and operations, describing the use case and also the business process. So in the UML, activity diagrams are intended to model the both computational and the organization process. If you take the example of flowchart, which is used to describe the workflow of your process or your algorithm or your program, same the activity diagram will give you the workflow. It is same as the flowchart, but it consists of some additional functionality. So we will see the purpose of activity diagram. It can be described as first to draw the activity flow of the system, to describe the sequence from one activity to another, then to describe the parallel, then branches and concurrent flow of the system. So this is the purpose of activity diagram. We'll see first the elements. So it is same as the first diagram which we have seen. It contains some actors, some elements, or we can say the activities. So the elements of the activity diagram is first the activity, means the activity which is performed by the system. Second is the association from one activity to another. Third is the condition, in which condition the activities are related or associated with each others, and the constraints. So let's see first the activity diagram. So this is the start of the process. It is denoted by the solid dot with the arrow to the particular activity. So the first activity is the customer sends the order request. Then again the arrow is to the second activity. The second activity is order request system confirms the receipt of the order. If the customer sending the order request, then it goes to the second activity, which is the confirming the receipt of the order. These two are the activities. Then it will go for the decision box. Now this is the decision box, also called as the decision check. If it is a normal activity or it is a normal request, normal order request, it will directly confirm the order. Or if it is not, then check for the special request, check for the special order. If still it is not a special order available, we can terminate the process. This is the termination at the end. And if it is a special order, then again confirm the order and go to the dispatch. After the dispatch, terminate the process. So this is the flow of the activity in the system, where the customer is giving some order for some goods and checking for whether it is available or not, and after dispatching, the customer is getting its order or the goods which he have ordered. So this system will provide the flow from one entity to another with proper notations. Here we have used the start notation, which is solid dot with arrow. Arrow is going to the entity, or we can say activity. Then the flow from one activity to another. Then the decision box. The decision box is nothing but checking the condition and the constraints. If the condition is yes, go forward. If it is no, then again check for the another condition and terminate. And then if the order is confirmed, then dispatch the order and terminate. So this diagram will show us the flow of the system, how the system flows from one activity to another after checking the condition and constraints. So this diagram will give us the overall flow of your software development process. So next we can again see the next diagram of the activity. Here is another example where the article is written by the author. So first, with the solid dot, we will always start with the solid dot because it is the initial node. It is initial condition. With solid dot, arrow to particular activity. So the first activity is the open article. Then after open article, it will go to the publish. The second activity is publish. After publishing, go to the moderate. If you publish a paper, you might have know these steps. So after moderating a read, now it's time to approve or not the article which is written by the author. So here is again the diamond condition which will check the control flow. So if the article is approved, then go to the set status to publish, means go to the publish state. If the article is not approved, then notify the rejection and terminate. And if the article is approved, go to the publish, and then final is a terminate. And that is your final note. So the activity flow will describe the how the activities of your software development process are working through one by another. What is the flow of the activities? How much activities are in your software development process? What are initial or overall constraints and the condition on which the activity flow? So hope you understand this activity diagram. Next type of diagram are the interaction diagram. We have mostly two types in your syllabus that is most important in interaction diagram. So the let's first see what is the interaction diagram. The interaction diagram purpose of the interaction diagram is to capture the dynamic aspect of the system. And so to capture the dynamic aspect, we need to understand what a dynamic aspect is and how it is visualized. So the dynamic aspect can be defined as a snapshot of running system at the particular moment. So we have this two perfect diagram for which suited in interaction diagram, the sequence diagram and the collaboration diagram. We'll firstly see the sequence and then collaboration, but firstly we'll need to identify key, what elements are essential before drawing the interaction diagram. So first we need to understand objects taking part in the interaction, which are the objects and which are taking part in the interaction. The second is the message flow among the objects, how the objects communicate with each other, what is the sequence of that message and the object organization. So let's see the first sequence diagram. Sequence diagram has the element which this is called as the lifeline, always denoted by the rectangle, with object or and class name. This is the object, this is the class name, this is the object, this is the class name, this is the user interacting with the system. Now this is the solid lines which describes the actress interaction. So the first, what the user will do, first will insert the card. Simple, this is the example of booking your seats for theater. You can see a theater and server. So insert a card, which is your debit might be credit. So insert the card for your theater. Then select a date. Select date for movie, which date you are going to see the movie. Then second, after selecting the date, the theater system will provide you the seats, which are the available seats. Now after submitting your order, then user will see the seats. He will confirm for particular seats, say 2, 3, 4. So you will confirm or you will submit the order to the theater. Then theater will go to the server to check the to submit the order. Here the checking will be done for the offer seats, and they will provide you the offer seat which are available. So after booking that offer seats, the order will be confirmed by the server. After the server confirmation, the order will be confirmed by the theater, and then it will be confirmed to the user. So this is the basic sequence diagram where one after another the messages are sent. Now there are different types of the message in sequence diagram. First is the synchronous message. Second is asynchronous message. Now synchronous message means the message waits for the reply before the interaction can move forward. Now here, first after inserting a card, the user is directly sending second message. In synchronous, this is the asynchronous type of communication or asynchronous type of messages. In synchronous, after sending one message, the user will wait until the theater will reply to him. Like this, select that, or we can say this, offer set. When the theater is offering a seat, he waits to user to order the seat or confirm the seat. After he is sending the seats, then only the server one, the theater will supply these things to server, and the server confirm the seats, and after the theater confirmation, the user will get the confirmation. So this is the synchronous type of communication where the first message is sent and the user waits until the second message arrives, and then again he will send the message. Means the user can wait until the next object is sending you the reply. After he will receive the reply, he will again send the message to the another object. So this is the synchronous, and in asynchronous, the object doesn't wait for any reply from other side. He will continuously try to reply the thing. Now if we want to create the message, then there is a stereotype create. So you can create the message by just stereotyping the create stereotype. Second is delete message. So just giving the crossing things, we can see in next diagram this all notation I am just explaining you. So delete message, just cross the things, then it will be called as a delete message. Then there is a self message. So self message, nothing but the self loop. If the theater is giving self loop, then it is called as a self message. It is also called as a reflexive message if the object want to send message to himself. Then there is a found message. The found message is nothing but if there is a message from unknown source, then we can call it as a found message. And activation bar is a rectangular bar which indicates the object is active during the interaction. And last one is the fragment is nothing but a situation. Fragment is nothing but a rectangular part in the system where it occurs when certain conditions occur. We have to give the fragmentation bar if some condition occur. We can see the another example which will give overall idea of all the things. So this is the message. We can say create message in the stereotype. If you give the stereotype, it is okay. If you give the method, it is also okay. So this is the order management system sequence diagram. So where the objects are customer, order, special order, normal order. First initialization, it will always start with customer. The arrow is call. Then the customer will request for the order, sends the order. Here we can see this is your activation bar in which customer remains active. This is your message. This is your self loop when the dispatch is calling itself multiple times. So this is a self loop, also called as a self message. So here the customer will send the order. The order system will see it is the available or not. The order is available or not. Then it will confirm the order to the special order. Then special order sees if it is a special order or the normal order. If it is special order, then it will dispatch. It will self call itself, confirm the order to the order system, to the order object. The order object will return to the customer. And if in this condition, if the order is not special order, it is the normal order, then this arrow will directly go to the normal order. Normal order will call itself, and then it will return to this directly to the order, and from order to the customer order. Then the special order will remain ideal. Here in this example, the normal order is ideal, but if the case is the normal order, then the confirmation will directly go to the normal order, not in the special order, and the normal order will give return to the order object and order object to the customer object. So there is another example I have said in elements, the fragment. So this is called as a fragment. If this is the example of your ATM, if the customer wants to withdraw some amount, he will give some account number and amount. Then the ATM will check the balance with the bank. Bank will look up for the balance. Here is another fragment. If the balance is sufficient, now what the bank will check if the balance is sufficient or not in the account to withdraw. So he will check the condition, balance is greater than the amount which is in the bank of the customer. So if it is yes, if it is true, then it will debit the amount from the customer's bank account and will return to the ATM, and then ATM to the customer. So this is the sequence diagram of your ATM transaction. For more details, you can go to the following link. Here you will find more details about the sequence diagram. I hope this session is understandable to you, in which we have seen the activity diagram and the sequence diagram, which is the part of the interaction diagram. The next one, collaboration, we will see in the next session. So if you have any query, you can just comment to the comment section. Thank you.